session about Rocket Chat. My name is Floris van Geel and I call myself a Drupal entrepreneur. An IRC, I'm Zelf. I still do use IRC in these days where everybody is on the Slack. And I'm also on the Twitters at OverOLAB. So, like I said, I call myself a Drupal entrepreneur, which means that about 60% of my time I do client work to keep the chimney up and to pay for my people, and 40% of the time I do own product development. We're going to talk about Slack, Rocket Chat, video chat integrations, how we made the Drupal module to do so, and then a roadmap where it's supposed to be going in the near future, and in the end, a call to action for all of you and all of you on the internet. So Slack, who here doesn't use Slack? There's no fingers, yes, one, two, one. Just a few people who don't use Slack at this time. 2 years ago, we were all on IRC, chatting together on the DrupalCon trip and all other channels where we collaborated in order to make Drupal better. And since recent, there was a choice to move all the groups and all the community work to a proprietary system called Slack. It has a little disadvantage that if you don't pay your $9 or $8 per user, which is quite a lot if you have to pay for the whole community, you don't have your history for a long time, as well as there is some improvement points on how you handle files and how you handle momentary stuff that flows along and you don't know what happened anymore. Then in Brazil, without the 35 million investment capital, a few people made a different chat solution, which is called Rocket Chat. It almost looks the same. It has like this bar with all the channels you have, and then the channel you're talking with. And if you look at from a technical point of view, the amount of integrations are about the same. It even has a Slack integration, so you can pop your user slightly, slowly, but firmly over from Slack to Rocket Chat. On the other hand, it does have a very nice integration. Let's first do that. It's built on top of Meteor. It's a JavaScript framework on Node.js. And it has a UBot integration, which is an open source general purpose bot that is used by GitHub and made by GitHub. And it has lots of integration features. We use this bot to integrate our own GitLab with Rocket Chat, for example. And furthermore, it has containerized scripts, so you can just take the source and put it in, for example, in a Docker or in another AWS instance or whatever hosting that you want or need to have. Also integrated is Jitsi Meet, which is how Hangouts was intended. So you have several.
My phone disconnected.
So, but you have several chat partners, and with those you can collaborate and talk together. And if you are inside a Rocket Chat channel and you start calling with each other, it just opens a new RSVP connection, and then you can chat with all your friends without anybody else going to that URL and having access to this chat room. So that's a real fancy, nice integration, and I'm amazed on how an open source product can be within 1.5 years to this maturity level. So if you compare some of the features, we see that it's almost for all platforms available, except Linux is also included for Rocket Chat. And of course, it's an open source license, so if you don't like the software or you see some bugs, you can just improve that instead of paying euros or dollars per user in order to use it. It can be self-hosted. you could host self-host Slack as well, but then you have to pay even more for a corporate license. Included screen sharing, the service integrations. I didn't make a comparison about that one because it's so many services. But all the important ones are available in both, including top level OAuth or SAML or LDAP integrations. So you can have your user land integrate into the chat users. Video conferencing by the Jitsi Meet, like I just showed you on the previous slide. And of course, they have all the clients. And as add-on to the Rocket Chat, you have a Slack client, so you can pull the people from the Slack. How did it start? I was looking at it. I saw online a video from the CTO of Rocket Chat, and I thought, that's interesting. And then I looked around on the internet, and I found this Jellyhus's repository that he did for his graduation challenge, and he did a Drupal 8 live chat integration. Live chat integration is when you arrive as an anonymous user on a website, then you have a little pop-up window. And with that pop-up window, you can contact sales, support, or whichever channel is needed. And therefore, maybe go from a visitor into a customer. Because that's one of the purposes of this little chat window. And then the code was somewhat functional. So what we did is improve it. But first, we should ask him, how is this license? And he didn't put any form of license on top of it. So I asked him, can you please make it GPL2 so that we can easily integrate it with Drupal.org and build on top of that. So a few days later, he just add the GPL2 license. It was nice. So a few days later, we did the first beta Drupal 8 release, then ported it back to Drupal 7, while most of us, if we have more complex, bigger websites, we can't all do it in Drupal 8, for it's too costly. Take some time in order to have all the contract there and then be able to do so. So it's new features are developed in both 7 and 8, depending upon what contract it's built upon. And in general, everything will be flattened out between the versions, that's what all the functionality is available. So, what do we have now? We currently have the live chat working, and besides that, the Rocket Chat itself with the Jitsi Meet and the video conferencing and all the functionality that is in Rocket Chat itself. How does this look? You have this little chat box that I talked about. You type in your message, somebody from operations or sales department or any other department that you define within the Rocket Chat can answer the question within the opening hours. If you are outside of the opening hours, then you directly go to a questionnaire field where you put your email, and that is then sent to an endpoint as a JSON with the data that is typed in. So it's easy to integrate within services, endpoints, automation systems. I was really amazed about your presentation yesterday with the integrations of the marketing automation. And these kinds of tools and blocks can add up there as well and increase the value of all these kinds of platforms and systems that we built in Drupal. So, for the roadmap in the scope. Personally, I would love to see all of us move away from Slack into a community self-sustained system. So interacting with your community. This is quite successful for us as an internal company chat, but also external with clients. So it can be easily integrated and utilized with company and public domain, NGO chats. And the next step would be to have a public chat. Public chat is always a bit difficult for you have the privacy concerns on one hand and you have security concerns on the other hand, for you don't want people to interact and do bad stuff on your chat and call service. For now, my call service is open to the internet, so everybody who finds the endpoint can just use it, because I want a proof of concept and I want to convince people that it's absolutely great and they should also be running and using it. So from there on, the next steps. There's two concerns here. I might go for the Drupal chat module and integrate on top of that, so that you have the Rocket Chat and use the Drupal chat API in order to get the multi-channel direct communications for people who logged in the website. From there you can do something with organic groups, that if you are a member of a group then you can chat together in a separate RocketChat channel. The API of RocketChat is quite extended, so we did a proof of concept with an admin user from the Drupal that can control all the facets, create new channels, elevate users to be promoted, and so forth. Yeah, come on. Then there's always the point of notifications. There is already a RocketChat app made, so if people have it on, they get their push notifications directly in the phone. And I'm not sure what Drupal role there should be. However, there is a notifications modules with Trello and all kinds of other integrations that can make this worthwhile. For file sharing, which is always a little bit of an issue, since even in Drupal 8, file handling is not optimal in Drupal. And in Iron Camp, we did a presentation on CMIS, which could connect to Alfresco, SharePoint, or any other corporate big document management system. And for us, as integrating chat and pointing to documents, it would be much more efficient to incorporate within the workflow than host everything in the Drupal file system and do it like that. But it's optional and open. One thing which would be a great asset, in my opinion, would be screen sharing within the chat. Not then necessarily to the desktop level, but to the browser level. That if a visitor visits your site and you want to support that visitor in his or in your site, you can use the web UI or the website for itself in order to direct and to take the visitor by the hand and show what you want to show. When you do this manually, you can also automate it afterwards, and that is really interesting. So this collaborating with people on documents and group conversations, the separate parts are already there. The only thing which is not yet there is interlinking it all and combining it to be a good solution. One of the bad things about Slack is that it only collects like 100,000 messages or 10,000 messages, not sure, and after that you have to pay. And since RocketChat is built on MongoDB, you can easily transfer data from one to another. We did a test where we had our older Docker-based RocketChat, and we want to migrate that to LXC container. So we just built the LXC container with Ansible to have the newest RocketChat, then updated the old RocketChat, and then just migrated the Mongo database, and it just worked. For the security part, it's SSL, it's behind a password, so it's about equivalent as security would be within the Drupal itself. However, I can imagine that we want to add some kind of cryptography on top of that. So that's I'm still not convinced that it's the solution. However, for the next slide, I want to introduce the matrix.org, which is a mesh system for chat services and other services. So between your instance of your Rocket Chats, the communication is encrypted. This would be a great asset for example, chatting for Drupal.org, where you have many Rocket Chat servers on many locations, and to do the communication and asynchronous synchronization between those, you use something like the matrix. Then we had another issue, since I wondered my people if they have a Drupal account on my Drupal site to be able to just do the Rocket Chat and not create another account in the Rocket Chat and forget that password or username. So we had to go for upstream, and 3 days ago this pull request for the Rocket Chat upstream, it was committed. Nice. So that means that now we can use the Drupal OAuth 2 server module, which is created by the Commons Guys, a very valid and lovely piece of software, to authenticate and automatically create the users in Rocket Chat. And that makes us able to make a seamless integration, so that a person has one account, could come from an external LDAP or other provider, it goes to the Drupal, Drupal does the OAuth 2 authentication and creates the user in the Rocket Chat, synchronizing the username, the the metadata that is needed there, and it could be a seamless integration. So, what are we looking for? People who do manage, test CRM solutions specifically within Drupal. Generally, adaptation in community communication. So, people who run a local group, start testing it, start helping it, doing it. General collaboration, sprinting, having great ideas in order to make things better. And of course, more integration with Drupal, but also with other systems. So in the end, the global message is stop slacking when the universe is our limit. Thank you. Is there any questions?
Does Rocket Chat has the possibility to do server-to-server communication, something like this? So if, like, Drupal.org would have a Rocket Chat community and somebody else, that I from the other channel could post also to the other one or not?
If you look at it from an app point of view, the answer is no. Then you have it the same way as in Slack, where you have all your servers.
Different servers.
Yes. However, with the matrix on top of it, you can do asynchronous multi-server solutions, the same as IRC does. If you go to Freenode, then you are not talking with one, you are talking with one server, which is close to you. But that one is synchronizing with many others around the world. And with the matrix, you can combine those and get the best of both worlds by using the mesh network.
Are you aware of any plans already for Drupal or for Rocket Chat or?
Not that I know of. That's why I'm giving a presentation and pushing it around within the community. And I hope that by doing so, I can convince many more people to be enthusiastic about this, and in the end, the Drupal community can use this system or an equivalent system. Since for me, it's really strange that we do everything open and everything GPL2, and then when we talk with each other, it goes by through Slack, NSA, and whoever you want to. Really crazy. Any other questions? Encrypted? Yes, Internally there is OTR. So if we have a personal message, and I click the OTR button, you accept OTR, and then besides SSL, our communication is directly encrypted. Yes. And with Matrix, if you have two instances, then the communication between both is automatically encrypted. So there's no human action needed in order to have this encryption. Any other question?
About the Matrix thing. I didn't really understand. It's something you plan or you're working on, or is this a platform that's already existing?
Yes, it's a platform that's already existing, and it's something that I plan on laying on top of the RocketChat Drupal integration. Yes. So it's double question, and both have the answer yes. And maybe I can show that one. No, sorry, my internet broke. Any other question? Okay, thank you for your attention.